I'll light them myself.
Let's give it a try.
Never suspected he believed in such things.
You know, when in Rome, do like the Romans do. I'm stuck. I can't move. Yay! Thank you, game, for... one of very few bugs I've encountered in this game. Getting stuck. Hello, bodyguard. Are you... Anna? There's nothing to steal in here. Okay, let's search the alcoves, I guess. Have to take the long way around, or... Is there another way of getting over to that one? Nah, whatever. Check out the ones that we come by. Nope, not that alcove. Be this one. Fragment of the script of a stage play. The biscotted witcher, Francois de Valère. Night, thick as mud, envelops a dense wood. A full moon hangs in the sky above the trees. Note, scenography must include a representation of the full moon. Wolves howl plaintively in the distance. A witcher walks through the woods in careful, measured strides. He wields a silver blade in his hands. Witcher, God damn it all. The moon is at its fullest. Long have I awaited this night. 3 weeks have I spent in the foul pit, all to catch a lone werewolf. At least the miller's daughter helped me while away the time. In fact, I leave only with a certain sense of regret. Perchance I should take her with me. We hear the snap of breaking behind the witcher. He turns around swiftly, his guard raised. He spies the werewolf. I've got you now, beast. Werewolf. The werewolf removes its mask. The witcher can see it is the miller's daughter. He is astonished. Does he not know what to do?
Well, what now? Will you kill me? Or perhaps you'll take me with you.
Interesting.
Blah, blah, blah. Avant-garde, schmavant-garde. It's all about two things. Coin and copulation.
I guess I'll check the other alcove and see if there's... No, that dude just came in here and passed the fuck out. Why... Ard symbol right there. So, I don't see a woman with a... I don't see anyone else in here. Ooh, hello. No, it's just to put that out. Alright, so there's no one actually in there. There's Henrietta. I'm like, come on, Anna. Try to keep up, girl. I know I dicked around and checked out the party. I thought there would be more things. Kind of like with the Blood and Wine. Or no, this is Blood and Wine. The Heart of Stone DLC. Where, you're at a party and... Yeah, I just want to steal the candles and everything like that. Do you have nothing in your hair? Alright. I was wondering if there's any more parts of that play. God damn it, some of these tables are just full of loot. I love it.
I'm sure you understand. There are a great many highly qualified candidates.
Then I shall have to convince you that ample generosity would be best invested in me.
We are busy.
Yes. Didn't mean to... Actually, I totally meant to interrupt you guys. Okay.
Do not touch.
I just wanted to see if you had a fancy brooch in your hair. Wait, so that's all the alcoves over here, or is there, like, another one? Now, it says search, but should I be using my Witcher senses and shit? It's locked from this side, so I'm gonna have to run all the way back to where that guard was. Don't see anything about having to use Witcher senses, so... Oh, no, it's just gonna go right through the water. Is Anna gonna follow me, though, through the water? No, she's hauling ass.
You can't catch me. I'm too fast for you.
I think someone either just passed out or her highness, the Duchess, just knocked them the fuck down. Man, there's a third. Look like there's a third alcove right here. Must be. Oh, well, what do you know? No? What? Ah, there's a purple orchid. You appear to be the woman I'm looking for, maybe.
Mm-hmm. It's the right flower.
Of course it is. A Kaviri orchid lends just the right contrast to her complexion.
Need to talk to your model. It'll only take a minute.
To me?
Lie still. You may speak, but for love's sake, do not move.
I will see how that turns out.
Wow. Impressive portrait.
I know the style, the stroke. This is Dorian Villes.
The gracious lady has heard of me?
I've heard Anna Henrietta herself wished you to paint her portrait once.
At one point, the palace chamberlain even wrote to me, but alas, ultimately refused my terms.
And what were your terms? You wanted her topless as well?
When he learned I only ever paint nudes, he severed all contact. He said he would not dare offend her illustrious highness with such a proposition. I've always longed to paint her. Such a shame.
I think you may still get your chance.
Ooh. Your highness. Saucy.
We came here to meet you, specifically.
To meet me? But why?
Cintrian Noble you came here with. Wanted to ask you about him.
Cintrian Noble? Ah! You must think I'm Cecilia.
Then...
Orchid confused me.
I told you not to move!
As she concluded her performance, Cecilia tossed the flower into the crowd. I caught it.
Oh. But
I did see the nobleman.
Really liked to talk to him. What did he look like?
He was wearing a mask, like everyone else.
Dark, masked.
Great.
Know where he might be now?
Anything?
He gave Cecilia a small gift, a heart-shaped box. Then they strolled off together towards the refreshment tables.
Excuse me, madame, monsieur, I cannot work like this.
Dude, you need to stop talking very quickly, but at least we have a lead. God damn it. Jesus. I beat the shit out of your favorite painter there, Anna. To search the refreshment table. Okay. Something, heart-shaped. Oh, hello, little loot.
Someone left their loot behind. Looks a little like dandelions.
This was scratched. Someone beat him with it once.
That's funny. You know,
no.
Might as well hit up each. What is this? A love letter. Laura, oh my dearest love, oh lone ray of sunshine, on the firmament of my life, I shall speak from the heart. For weeks I have been shooting stolen glances in your direction, hiding the hope I dare nurture deep within my bosom, that perhaps you feel for me. Even one iota of the affection I feel for you. I have waited long, gathered the courage to confess my feelings for you. I would certainly be waiting still had you not appeared at tonight's soiree in the company of that womanizing, carousing, drivel-scribing, pretentious pig named Alphonse de Reside. Reside? When I saw that emaciated turd fawning over you, I immediately knew I had to act. I turned to the best weapon in my arsenal, the quill and the well-turned phrase, and began writing you this letter. Forgive me, it is written on a napkin, for I had nothing more appropriate at hand at the time. Oh, most marvelous of all women, do not believe a word he whispers in your ear. He is as slippery as a viper, and twice as venomous. Reject his advances and let me walk hand in hand with you. Feel your grapes and with your radiant happiness to the heavens themselves.
Oh, feed you grapes, not feel your grapes. It's, I thought that was like a euphemism for grab her tits. Yours forever, Fabian.
Oh, my amour, my sunbeam flittering across the firmament of my life.
Oh, she's reading the letter. Tree, what?
It a Fistek, artist's way of numbing their existential pain.
Ooh, yeah. Fistek's like cocaine. I think Fistek is kind of the equivalent of cocaine in this world. How about you? You buy heart-shaped boxed? Box?
Empty heart-shaped box.
Hey, cool.
Cecilia must have left it behind.
It looks like it held a flask of perfume. Gift from the synth.
Well, that I can work with. There we go.
Let's follow it.
Well, you follow me while I follow it. That work? That seem fair? Oh, they did not take a straight path, did they? Charlie, or no, Family Circus their ass all around this place. This will probably lead me to that door where that guy's guarding it, I would imagine. Hell, they took the same path we did. They lit the lanterns and all that. But they didn't check out the Ofiri dude. That guy actually put on a pretty decent act. We need to get on their side of this door.
Sorry, only artists in the Mandragora allowed.
Come, we must consider what to do.
I can always just beat the shit out of him.
I'd recognize that voice anyway.
Oh, well, that solves that issue.
You must be mistaking me for someone else.
I served 15 years in the palace. Your Grace, I'd not mistake you for anyone.
I thought he was going to tear his whole face off.
We are here incognito, on state business.
Yes, Your Grace. How may I serve?
Don't tell anybody you've seen us.
I hope we can count on your discretion.
Of course. I shall be silent as the grave.
Good, good, good.
Looking for Cecilia Bellant. Seen her?
She's in her dressing room, where she went with a nobleman. They clearly were drawn to each other.
What did the man look like?
Is she gonna be dead when we get to her?
Broad-shouldered, a black beard peeping out from under his mask, and he spoke with a foreign accent. A drawl of sorts.
Sintra-ish, hey?
It must be him. We must get to the dressing room, quickly.
Yes, Your Grace. I'll take you.
No, stay here. Anyone tries to flee, you stop them.
Understood.
Thank you, guardsman. Now, please...
Upstairs.
Okay, I thought he was going to be in the way. I'm like, please get the fuck out of the way. Now, is this woman going to be horribly violently dead? Because it wouldn't be the first time we're following the lead of somebody, and it's like, oh, this person's... Oh, man. Happened with Horson Jr., happened with, what the hell was, it was, oh, hey, they're in the door on the left. I have to try the door on the right, just in case. The man from Sintra. And she's dead. Go figure.
That must be Cecilia.
Cut her throat? I thought she had bites.
No pulse. We're too late.
Nah, it wasn't.
He slit her throat. The brute.
The animal.
Didn't go out the door. Guard would have noticed. Might still be somewhere here.
Or he turned into a bat.
You must find him before he harms another. I shall alert Oriana at once. She should bring her soiree to a close.
No.
Geralt, I will be fine. Go after that rogue. I shall fetch help.
He won't listen, so... Damn, girl. Now that is a common thing that they tend to do. Is like, oh, heading up to a room where the evil ne'er-do-well that we're looking for went with a woman moments ago. And they seem so happy. And now she's dead. Fuck. Went out the balcony, though.
Killed her.
Now, there's no other place he could have gone. It's not like he's hiding under the covers, and there's no canopy above the bed, just the post.
It's his. Tore down the door, made a platform.
Huh.
Clever.
Very clever.
It must be pretty strong, too.
To be able to rip the whole fucking door off? I would imagine so.
Climbed this ladder.
Oh. I thought, well, hello.
Broke the flower pot when moving the door, then stepped in the soil.
Ooh, he left me some footprints. Ah, that works.
Footprints made by soiled boots.
Rookie move. CSI Geralt. I feel like maybe... Oh, I can't put my swords on. Bitch. Well, fine.
Could still be here. Need to stay alert.
If he's a real man, then... Oh, smash the mirror, hmm? I guess this may end a fist fight. Oh no, he went out another window. The collected verse of Gonzales de Vercio? Love. To love is to build a house of cards or play a game of chess. But one wrong word or ill thought move, and you must start it all afresh. Tide. Whenever I watch the tide recede, cold coils of fear grip round my heart. Will the seas sneak back, calm and sure, in the dark of night, as they have before? Or will they stay on distant shores, leaving crushed shells and washed up dreams, as memory of serfs of yore? Cool story, bro.
Looks valuable, but it's not what he came for.
No, it seems like he was escaping the murder scene, Geralt. Not really a... Ooh, there's the knife.
Knife, richly ornamented, used during the fight, probably.
The fight or the murder?
Somebody took a knife to the painting, looks like.
Wait, was there like a big fight in here? Jesus. Okay, well, finish looting everything that's yellow and then make the rounds of what the fuck happened in here.
Smashed mirror. Someone crashed into it hard, then sank to the floor.
But there's no sign of another person. Unless he chucked them out the window and there's probably a dead body out there. We'll see. We'll figure that out in just a moment. Oh, God.
Links of a snap chain. Jewel must have been on it. Jewelry box. Lock's busted. Picked open, probably.
Broke into a jewelry box, hmm? Okay.
Sconce is bent, smeared with blood. Someone tried to grab it. Blood on the window frame. Someone climb out, fall out.
Thrown out, maybe? Seems most likely, or more likely, that they're thrown out.
Empty inkwell. Knocked over, turned toward the room.
So, thinking someone came in with a knife. Find out what happened here. Well, I looked at everything else. Unless there's anything I might have overlooked, or... You ain't gonna give me shit about the... No, I did overlook that one.
Precious stone. Bloody fingerprint on it. Thief came for this. Must have. Tiny chain links next to it. From a snapped necklace. Seems there was a struggle.
Yeah, there's a...
The jewel was in the box, it seems.
Full out, throw down, strip down fight.
They fought, struggled, that's clear. Ended with one of them flying out the window. Fall had to have killed them.
Kind of figured that. Window,
so our Sentryan must have been the flyer.
Oh, maybe. Wait, is that redhead we saw earlier? Maybe she's a vampire? Hey, guys. How's it going? Not what it looks like. Okay,
so
I guess.
Is the tracker. A witcher, yes?
Indeed, this is him. We found the body together. Then he set off in pursuit of the killer.
And ended up here, but I've only found evidence of a fight. Seems the Sentryans killed his last. Finally failed this time. Shame it happened too late for Cecilia.
Poor girl. Always told us she chose her males badly.
Males?
I would never have suspected she could arrive with a murderer.
That sounds something a vampire would say.
The staff.
This bitch is a vampire.
See to her body at once. Meanwhile, we should sit. I will tell you everything in full detail.
Damn, her character model looks great. Some of those birds are stuck in that statue and they're freaking the fuck out.
To burgle, rifling through my possessions.
What did you do? Summon the guards?
No, I beat the shit out of him.
I feared he'd escape, refused to give him the chance. He stood with his back to me, so I attacked. He struck his head on a picture frame as we struggled. He was bleeding, dazed, and then he drew a knife. Everything happened very quickly then. I knocked the weapon out of his hand and pushed him hard. He
fell out of the window.
Just so.
None too wise picking a fight with an armed robber.
Why? Because I'm a woman, in a frock rather than plate. I can take care of myself, I assure you.
You've shown that.
A mere ornament, but plunged into an eye, it can be as effective as a blade.
Probably even more effective.
Claim the man was trying to rob you when you walked into the room?
Yes. He stood over my dressing table, pouring through my jewelry.
He broke into your one jewelry box.
After this is my guess. Picked it up while searching.
Why, that's the heart of Toussaint. Oriana, how did you ever come to have it?
The heart of Toussaint?
Many years ago, from a young woman.
I imagine you'll want that back as well, since it seems like it's incredibly valuable.
Jewel seems important. Why?
The heart is an heirloom. It belonged to my family for years. Then it disappeared. I didn't think we would ever recover it.
Seems someone is very determined to find it. The thief left his tool bag behind. Found this drawing inside it. Look.
A perfect diagram of what he was looking for, or trying to steal. But why the Heart of Toussaint?
The Heart of Toussaint. Representation's pretty faithful. Centurion must have been on a job. Got very clear instructions what to look for.
So it is not him we seek, but his employer.
Bastard. Called it, though.
Is this the only evidence we found?
Also happened on the weapon he attacked Oriana with. Hunting knife. Used to skin game. Got an emblem on its hilt.
This crest is used by the Lords of Duntine. The present master of the castle is a passionate hunter. Our next lead, perhaps.
Duntine. Remember the place. Abandoned ruin just a few years ago.
More recently, the family's last heir, Roderick, returned to his ancestral seat and restored the castle.
Know any more about this Roderick?
His grandfather was an advisor to Queen Ademarta. The family received those lands as a grant for his service. Roderick is quite the recluse. He avoids society.
A brown recluse? Don't fuck with those. They're dangerous.
Though the latter term is imprecise, as they seem more akin to vandals with crests on their shields.
Now, I guess we need to go check them out, too.
Oriana, everything we discussed here, hope you'll keep it to yourself. Counting on it, in fact. Word gets out he, failed in his attempt to steal the jewel. His employer could run. We need to proceed cautiously.
Discretion is in the interest of us all. I'll not ask what this is about, just as I expect not to be troubled about it again. By anyone.
Forgive me, Madam Oriana, but might I have a word?
You must excuse me a moment.
You know, following the story directly, not getting sidetracked or going on any other missions, this is just a big, like, Miss Marble mystery and such like that. It's a whodunit, who's behind it, and following leads and clues. It's truly just a big detective story, I guess. I think Miss Marble is kind of based around detecting and crime solving as well. Yeah, this is really cool. I never really stuck with a storyline for long enough without getting sidetracked and distracted by everything. So what do you think about Oriana?
Oriana, any thoughts?
Few make me feel awkward, but in her presence, I sense anxiety, discomfort.
The drawing. It's on the same type of paper the victim's names were written on.
Oh.
Drawing the same ink, too.
A little bit bigger.
The work of our blackmailers.
Who were not only behind the beast's murders, but also stole the Son Real and sought to steal the heart of Toussaint.
Look, the wine, the jewel, both tied to you intrinsically. Coincidence? Not something I'm willing to believe. Worried about one thing. that somewhere at the end of this scheme, Plan might call for an attempt on your life.
And you gallivanting out at parties with me isn't a really good idea. Maybe you should be under heavy guard. Although I do enjoy your company, Your Highness. It's just really dangerous.
Sister, Siana might be among the schemers. She left court when we were children. My parents banished her from the duchy.
And she's the rightful heir to the throne, isn't she? Why was she banished?
What did your sister do to get banished?
Siana was cursed.
I've known several people that have curses, but... Age?
No. She was born at an inopportune moment.
Is that really a curse?
They said she was touched by the curse of the Black Sun.
Okay, that's really a curse.
Is it true? Can an individual be evil because they were born during the wrong lunar phase?
No. Could be the case. But
because they were treated like lepers from birth, isolated, prodded, ostracized. Couldn't have had it easy, Siana.
She was angry at the whole world. She felt inferior, felt pain, though she masked this with confidence, arrogance even. She could also be cruel at times. I recall one such situation. She persuaded Cedric the Coolbird that she could see the future in her dreams.
Hmm.
We were children, and Cedric's brother was smitten with me. It was an innocent childhood crush. Siana knew of it. She told Cedric of a dream she had had, that he would die at the hands of his own brother.
And then it ended
Cedric
up happening?
Stole his father's sword.
Oh, shit.
His brother. She destroyed two lives with a prank. Cedric mourns to this day.
Cedric, you know, kind of went a little crazy.
In the end, they forced her to leave the palace. A decade passed. More. I've missed her terribly since.
So, Henrietta is probably 25. So she hasn't seen her since she was like 15? No, said they're young children. Maybe she's even younger.
Think your sister might be involved? Why?
You see, I recall her always being rather possessive, throwing jealous fits if I had something she didn't.
Here, that's normal for sisters. Rivalry.
Yeah, but she was treated like a goddamn demon with a curse.
There are times I miss that very much. The wine, its theft was the first clue. That's very much like her. She always did enjoy stealing my toys. But I grew almost certain when I saw the heart of Toussaint. Siana received it from father as a gift. At a time when my parents thought of her as but an ill-behaved little girl, someone wanted some of my wine. The same someone ordered our family jewels stolen or recovered. It's my sister. It must be.
A fallen princess satisfying whims, going after lost luxuries? Could be right.
Fits.
Your mission has gained new import. You must go to Dun Tyne, and if Siana is there, you must find her. No matter what she did, she is not to be harmed in any way, shape, or form. You must make sure of that.
Yeah, I can do that. I'll see to it.
I'll find her if she's there.
I hope you do. I very much wish to talk to her. Sister to sister.
Your Grace, Geralt, I'd like to introduce...
Regis! What a surprise! I had no idea you were in Beauclair.
Hey! Regis, you brought your buddy.
My very dear friend, Detlaf van der Eretain.
On a
arrival from Nazel.
Little bit more of a...
Our combined resources to the witch's hunt.
Peaceful encounter.
Ah, yes. Splendid.
She has no clue that Detlaf is the one. Oh, shit.
So I invited Regis in for a glass of wine.
Yeah, they're all vampires.
Ages, literally.
Well, that explains how you kicked the shit out of that robber pretty easily. All true.
Few I can rely on like I can on Regis. And I hope he thinks the same of me.
Curious. It seems opposites really do attract.
Don't be fooled, dear. Geralt has many merits. He merely hides them from the world very diligently.
You said you're both aiding him with his contract. It involves the Beast of Beauclair, I suspect. Master Witcher, maybe you could satisfy my curiosity. What's it like going toe-to-toe with a monster, knowing you've only two options, to kill or be killed?
There isn't always two options.
I plunge at every monster I see, sword in hand. Talking gets the job done for some.
I wonder what a monster might have to say to you.
It might want to apologize.
My word.
Oh.
For what might the monster wish to apologize to a witcher?
For killing. Though at times there is no choice, when loved ones are at risk and require protection.
Just like humans.
Same as humans. Put them in that situation, they'll kill too.
You understand this. It must be why you and Regis are friends. If I understand you correctly, you would rather help a monster than kill it.
If possible, yeah. Or at least try.
Enough about
Oh, man. Pretty intense, though, staring match.
I spent time there as a child.
Fond memories?
It was wonderful. I was positively entranced by the land's fashions.